the one person I'm looking for acknowledgement, I am pure.
Our, how to say it? One person under ours.
Do you have your attention, please?
Okay, starting at this one person from all our collaborators from the different cities we didn't introduce till now. It's Daniel Koryakovich, it's the guy with the yellow shirt. You might all have already spoken with him because he is here since 3 days that we didn't introduce him. He came quite late to our teams and we invited him to come to Bombay as kind of secret observer, as an observer who observes the whole conference.
Sorry.
He will also write something like a report. We don't know yet how this report will look like, but he will write a report. And I just make a short introduction who it is. Daniel Koryakovich is a researcher, curator, and writer based in Paris and sometimes in Zurich as well. He curated exhibitions and collaborative projects on sound, installation, performance, and public art. He's a co-director or was co-director of Memory Cage Editions, which doesn't exist anymore, unfortunately. He was also curating the exhibition program of the Kunsthof Zurich, that's an exhibition space, an outdoor exhibition space of the Zurich University of the Arts. From 2008 to 2014, he curated, amongst other projects, the multi-regional exhibition and research project Quadrilogy. It was situated in Berlin, Athens, and Hong Kong, among other cities. Presently, he is working on a book on Lorenz Wiener, a publication with conversation with Lorenz Wiener. He is also co-editor of the Torrent magazine. Torrent, a magazine on source materials by artists, which I think expect the number for the next few months, I think. Yeah. It's worth it. Okay. So, now we go on with the discussion, or I try to provoke or the discussion a few minutes ago. I just like to collect, this is only for me, but I had some different points which I thought are very interesting to discuss more, but I think we have to discuss that. One of these points was, which we already discussed this morning, we had an introduction by Ranjit, was about the problematic about the public sphere, public and public space, also the public debates in this context. And another one which was quite interesting for me, which I realized is something which Cosmin touched, it's the shifting debates from, or even shifting public spheres from the medical to the political, and from there from the political or the trade to the economic and even to the arts. This kind of shifting debates, which go from one field goes to another field, or public spheres from one to another field, and finally, these public spheres overlap. I think it's a quite interesting phenomenon. Another one which occurred to me was when I was listening to the Mexican people from Mexico City. We discussed that very shortly yesterday. The difference between memorial and monuments, the background of that, what does it mean? Usually in Europe, you have a lot of monuments. They are used to symbolize the heroes of the old nation. The memorials is more or less the contrary. The memorials usually they represent, let's say, the victims of the nation, of the activities of the nations. That was specifically in Germany in the 80s a huge discussion about the memorials for the murdered Jews during the Nazi time. So this was kind of differentiation, which is a discussion which I thought is very interesting, specifically with the examples you brought from Mexico City and what you do as the antropologist in this context. Another thing which occurred to me very interesting was, of course, also the differentiation between a critical activity, a social activity, and a political activity in the arts. We don't have to discuss that now, I just want to mention it. And then, last but not least, the cultural exchange or the exchange of cultural practices which we learned from specifically from the people from Hong Kong, which I thought is also very interesting. Why this specific exchange happens under what circumstances and what especially. I remember that Giorgio spoke about Shakespeare, who got a lot of appreciation in the 18th century in Germany, and why happens that at what time, and what is the reason that that happens after a lot of long time of French influence, then it shifted to the influence of Shakespeare in literature. As an example. And then, as I mentioned before, the relationship between or the between complicity and coziness, what you touched just before the interruption. And then of course how we can maintain dissent in our activities and don't go too fast to that what we usually think it's a thing of the democracies, that means consensus. In fact, it's the contrary. A democracy builds up on dissent and not consent, on the negotiation of that. These are a few points which I thought is very interesting. I just want to stress one point. I don't want to make a misunderstanding, because two days ago, I spoke about the specific method which we, as a research institute, did in Zurich. That method was that we scan the city and we define some factors which are very relevant for a city, and that this would be the starting point for artistic works or artistic research. I just wanted to say that what we did in Zurich, that might have been very, very important and necessary for Zurich, but it doesn't mean that this is, should be the case for other cities. That was just for our context method, which was absolutely appropriate. So I just want to say, this is not something which we would like that something like that would happen in the project draft, as we are many collaboratives and many different people with different approaches. We have all different approaches and we have exchanged under each other, I hope, the next few months, but it doesn't mean that one or the other imposes something to another city. I hope I could make me clear. Thank you. So, to start the discussion, maybe I heard that you, Ivan, a Christian Hindu from the Nobody, you had two points which you think would be interesting to at least put in the space or in the room that could be discussed.
The question is...
You want another mic?
Yes. My personal interest is because I have a lot of different views on one specific topic, and for me it's very constructive and very interesting. But for me, the following step would be to fix the position of how to go on, and to go on as a collective and not a single person and single project groups. So maybe there is a solution to find three or four topics that we can say it's our commons, and maybe we discuss it from different angles and different viewpoints. So for me, it's one result that I saw from different groups, that post-colonial discussion is one topic, what is commons, and maybe it's for the Swiss people more the post-migration discussion, but to put some specific points and to fix it, and maybe the development of the following year will maybe be more concentrated on that.
To echo Yvonne and perhaps provide a partial answer, I think one thing that we all have in common, and which to me in fact represents perhaps the most captivating or the most promising dimension of draft, is the cross-disciplinarity. The fact that people from different, not just different disciplines, but really different practices are working together. So I think we should keep an eye on that. But that collaboration is very rare indeed. So we produce, you know, if we produce knowledge, it will be in a mode which neither universities nor the media really endorse. So I think that's tremendous.
I found your remark quite interesting, but I feel that it is problematic to jump into the notion that there could be a collectivity. There's both the distance and the lack of a path. But I have a thought that has to do with something that I will discuss in commensurability. There, I think that we found, or at least I was very surprised to find, that we have two places where we are not talking about the same thing very clearly. One is this problem of the public sphere, the civil society, the public, and the other one that I was very happy to see, to listen to Christoph, which is this, the possibility that there's a place where there's a difference between monument and memorial. I need to tell you that I went to check the Spanish dictionary, and we have a very authoritarian idea of dictionary that is totally colonial, and the Royal Academy of Spanish Language argues that we should not use the word memorial coming from English in any relation to the question of monument. So we have a royal monarchic order to fulfill to avoid that distinction and that contamination. So there's even that very funny moment that I went to check the dictionary, and there was another European order in relation to this problem. What I suggest is that rather than trying to reach a point of collective creativity, we explore a certain contamination and intervention, which might be that there could be a way in which a specific member of one of the teams comments or contributes into the work that is being developed across in another place, maybe by opening a space where it becomes part of a production, or where there's a writing, which could be also a way of welcoming all the possible misunderstandings, distortions, and conflicts that those relations. I was thinking in Chodelat's measurement of bodies, and I think that we can pirate that image in doing that. I mean, I'm like touching the some body part of St. Petersburg measure.
It was very important to listen also to this teaching, but actually, based on our educational experience, we would like maybe to do it otherwise and introduce another method, speaking for each other. Just imagine that we would spread in maybe three groups, exchanging ideas and projects, and then another one explained. In Mexico, happen things like that. That's how we understood it. And kind of mediate the whole order. And so that kind of mediation, speaking kind of the voices of the other, we get very strong kind of insights into what's going on, and also create, immediately reveal certain misunderstandings, which definitely on the table right now. And that would really help better than just a series of watching and form presentation.
You mean long term?
No. Just as a walking method. Just like, you know, you stay together 3 hours and then you speak what we are doing in video. Not really explaining what we are actually realizing. What definitely would like to hear. Sometimes it's really creating a little, I don't know, what you really got from our presentation. And that would really help a little bit to get step further.
Can I, as an audience member who wasn't presenting, make a comment? I think there was one other thing that I felt was sort of stepped in and out constantly of this entire 3-day conference was, you know, this idea of creative cities and the fact that everybody, almost everyone touched upon, you have 9 cities, you have 9 conversations and multitudes of threads coming through there. And there was an interjection of the rural with peace sign off. And I think today, even Christoph, you mentioned Hamburg as being a booming city. But for every Hamburg, there are 10 other cities that aren't. And there was one thing that, throughout most of today, what troubled me was this excessive preoccupation with the urban. And looking at, to a certain extent, the rural on the other side of the continuum. But I wish, maybe next year, something to think about is how is it that there could be some focus on what's along the continuum. And in this entire conversation of how creative you are in terms of the projects that you're doing and works that you're writing, how do you address positions of power that you occupy, positions of privilege that you occupy, living in the earth?
Me?
Yeah.
Yeah, it is really meaningless, but I need to say that the instruction in the Spanish dictionary, so not to use the word memorial, says that it is preferable to use monument, because memorial has been cast or copied for English. So the phrase, and this is in Spanish, there's a new flower offering to the memorial of the victims of the attack to Leningrad is wrong. So even the geography of that exchange is fully implied in the fact of the foreignness of the term. And I sort of feel that, going back to what I was trying to suggest, that if we allow that noise in our process of working, we could probably arrive to something that could be interesting. I mean, somehow, a subtitling, let's put it this way. I mean, I'm suggesting probably to have a subtitling in, because I understand that we need to go back to our phones and produce something, no? And this looks very, very, that makes it useful both to have this separation, but there will be a way that does not necessarily have to be identical, but needs to be discussed, to produce those miscegenations. And my suggestion would be that probably by chance, that there's a combination of cities that is made on a practical method, and then we have those things discussing how is it that they can interact, and that way we probably can get into having specific decisions. Once everybody has somehow listened to the others and always knows where is that everybody's going, but it's like having a secondary report. I mean, like a foreign, let's call it a friendly foreign power. In the argument, because it's true that this thing, I mean, I found it very, very interesting. I said it to several people that something I was very much distrustful at the beginning of the conference, the fact that we were put in our different city tables, ended up being very interesting. Yeah, and it is, I would have usually gone against that idea. In principle, I felt it was like going back to a moment of national representation that I wanted to avoid. But in practice, now that we are not framed in our minds on that basis, I think that it actually revealed a lot of very specific practices and noses. So I want to retain that, but somehow to complicate it.
I just have a last association, I think you were talking about, or like trying to figure out what we have in common, and also saying that we're speaking unclearly, and I was also, just referring to this, what we also have in common, I guess, is English as a language of exchange, because if we're talking about dissent, discourse, and communicating, maybe we should also focus on the form or the language we're using, so I don't know, I don't have any proposition, I'm just bringing this to the table that this kind of translation process maybe is also somehow important yeah, because we all think and live and work in our cities and in our other languages as well. But we meet here in this language. So it's just something that came up.
Do I understand you right, Kortemok, that you say it would be interesting to consider what we do all in a very different manner because we come from very different contexts and everything has another meaning in our specific context. Your proposition would be that we would work in relation, let's say, to something what we understand on the public sphere in relation to that and consider this. So that all our different approaches we have, the different issues we have, the different methods we have, the background we have, that we would consider it in terms or in relation to public sphere. Is it that what you mean?
No, what I was meaning is that as for the next step, when we each of these teams needs to have a process of production, that we complicate it by having during that process of production a specific relationship with another member or team that is intervening in our process. And the way that intervention takes place is one of the elements that has to be negotiated or discussed. Probably understanding that the person, the location that is in charge of some production can have a certain authority. Let's try to illustrate. Suppose, assume that we make a lottery and our colleagues from Cairo are going to work with Shodelat. So then we need to have a moment when they actually, depending on what Shodelat wants to do, they will need to suggest how they want to collaborate. And Shodelat needs to keep a certain authority on deciding how they get that collaboration. But that the process of this complicated strategy that not collectivity, but at least sharing of a process.
Yeah, I think one of the interesting things of the conference was that we were allowed to see our differences, forms of thinking our specificities. I mean, what is going on Cape Town was helpful for Mexico to think the problems we want to address in a way, or what is the state in terms of our context and our desire to create something, but also maybe for the production of our group that is Teatro, maybe like the production of Shtodelat was really important to rethink some of the stuff. So maybe we can open the conversation so there is some interaction during this year to have more exchange and more debate that we can kind of make a more complex panorama of those nine cities.
If you don't mind, I think we also need to think centripetally, not just centripetally, if you know what I mean. Because at the end of the day, we'll be in our back home, right? 364 days, and then 1 year of internet. We'll be in touch online. So we've got to be realistic, and I think the Arab intervention is our local good, actually. That's where draft would have an impact. Though the moments of sharing are great. So I want to propose also this centrifugal model where we will actually go even deeper into our local communities as well as centripetally to get coming together and share. Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah, I'm not so fast in making suggestions. But actually, I think this is a really good idea that you just suggested, I think. But I also find it extremely helpful how I understood your first suggestion, that you somehow get an insight, outsider into your inside. And this shift of perspective can be so super helpful for projects. I mean, now we have maybe most of the artists, theorists, critics, and so on are quite used to traveling around and to the shift of perspectives, maybe. But if you work in a community and you work with new people, they are not so used to that. And sometimes this kind of, if
to do, for instance, projects that are very based in communities, like I would say half of my practice is, then the perspective can fall apart. And this is a very practical thing I would hope for in a thing like that. Because yes, we have, for instance, very tough, well-organized right to the city movement in Hamburg with 80 initiatives in it, but only very, very few people look outside and relate to, for instance, the right to the city movement attempts in Istanbul from 2008, or to the very well-organized network in the States, or the network in Durban, which is more at the fringes of the city. I would not suggest to shift from the city and the urban to the rural if we invite cities. I think one should really, first of all, I don't like it, I must say. And I think it's not a perspective, actually. But if one did that, I have two cousins who are farmers, and they are actually networking internationally and visiting. Farmers visit each other. If they have a little bit of money, then they start, they are internationally halfway organized. They could be better organized, definitely. But they do this, and one could think, of course, about a project like that to exchange regions or something. Which would be an exciting project, and I think some artists work on this, but I think we don't have to shift focus too much. Thank you. No suggestion from others.
I mean, what you just said, nearly nobody more. And the artists, creators are planning a lot today. So, I mean, and most of us in our circle who are sitting here,
yeah,
we already knew from each other,
yeah,
at least we knew from each other that we existed, and we didn't know what we especially do. So, there is already this basic,
yeah,
knowledge. The other thing is that what we somehow like to work on, there are specific issues we are all struggling with. One of that would be, or is, what we, I mean, the starting point, as I pointed out in the first day, was once this so-called public art. What is it? We don't use it, this word, because we are a little skeptic, because it has a specific tradition and is somehow narrow. That's why we much more use this notion of public debate and creating a public sphere that's much more open, and it's also open of all the creations which are done in the field of art, the medias and methods you work. So this context is much more interesting than what we usually call public art. And in this, with the notion of public debates, what art and how and in which extent art is involved in debates, public debates, that's quite an interesting thing. And that's thing which we, I got the impression from all the people who are here, are all working in and also struggling, and all in another way. Because we have different contexts, so the people in Cairo, they work very, very differently than what is appropriate, let's say, in Zurich or in Hamburg. And that's quite an interesting thing, to observe that, to work that for each other. But also, you look very skeptical.
It's number one
for me. It's an official
skepticism. I don't have a
skepticism.
But there are so lovely love affairs between cities that cities don't know about. Like the imitation of politicized wrestling from Mexico City in Hamburg, for instance, is a 10-year-old tradition. Repeated every year, and whenever there's a big investors project coming up, the wrestlers come together, build one of the projected houses as one of the fighters, and then the robo wrestler comes in and destroys it. And it's happening twice. So it's kind of funny.
What?
Okay, you know the wrestlers, Mexican wrestlers,
no,
wrestlers,
Indian
wrestlers, very
thing you could tell 1,000 things about the whole history of the mask in Mexico.
Anyway, the German robots.
Yeah, no, in Germany, there's a group called Rock and Wrestling. They make one event once a year, which is a kind of travesty of wrestling.
That's really
but wrestling itself is also a bit of a travesty of wrestling.
So, all the cities have something like that, a kind of intercultural exchange. In Zurich, you have in Europe the biggest Latino festival every year. It's the largest one because they have such a huge South American community. They have their own, even own rules somehow in the districts. But I want to say, I mean, all we are all connected in this intercultural stuff. Rachi, you wanted to say something?
Thanks for cutting me off. That was not the bracket I was talking about.
No, we have other people who like to say
something.
How about explain the question afterwards? No, just another thought on this idea of kind of carrying it through the idea of cities and how each of the cities was represented, or each of the practices was represented in the idea of a kind of an idea of a city. And although I think that's amazingly interesting as a beginning, now as you talk about the next phase and the next kind of steps, it's not only the process, which I think is interesting, but the processes that I've witnessed over the last 3 days are actually, they're quite internalized, and I think today was a very interesting discussion about the film. The whole idea of the questioning of the film was really about how do individuals from different urban centers or cities or contexts actually start to identify with the characters or the feelings or the emotions or the processes of the film. And sometimes it's not so easy just to do that by using your own internalized process, what each practice kind of knows and what they've developed over the years. But in two interesting examples of projects that, I mean, one I talked about the first day, the idea of inserting something that is foreign to everybody, which has to force you to come to a kind of level playing field in a way, and all your ideas develop simultaneously at the same time and kind of feeding each other without having one being the kind of majority or one being more important, because that identification process, I think that's a very long one and it involves a lot more thought. It involves maybe multiple projects over years to be able to kind of develop it in a very sophisticated way. And the other project, which I didn't discuss the other day, but it's something that my wife actually worked on a few years ago, which was called the Collaborative Film Project. And it was started out of Detroit, in the US, where they took 25 filmmakers from all over the world and they all wrote a story together of a feature film. And the story was based off of one object that they were given, the same object that everyone had to write a story about. And each one had to kind of connect that narrative over about 13 cities internationally. And I can't say it was an amazing film, it was very disruptive in a way, but what was beautiful about it was that you saw that same object which meant something to somebody and you saw it translated in a very different way, yet it had to connect. It was the force that the processes that they used forced them to kind of connect and work with each other. And at the end of the day, it was one project. So maybe it's not only about the process, but it is about something that physically could almost bind you in a way to an image or maybe a presentation, which could also be an interesting part of the process.
Thank you, Roger. We have to be aware that in a few minutes we have this Skype with Rita, is it correct? So, in 3 minutes. So, is there one last comment from the collaboratives? Shanghai.
I'm still a little puzzled as to what we are going to do next. And there are now 3 things running in my head. One is what I learned yesterday, which is that Gitanjali, Rupali, Prasad, and Camp have to collaborate. But I have something else now that I actually like much more. I also appreciate what Giorgio and Christoph say. They're already working on projects and they want to go deeper in them. Their own cities and maybe on their own. So,
with outside.
With outside.
In my case, with outside.
I think one has to really consider what the box says. We have known each other and have somehow flirted with projects for close to 10 years. And with Cairo and Bombay, it's the same thing. But yes, all of us want to put one hand in St. Petersburg at some point now, and also to Cape Town. So are these things possible? Because I really feel maybe we don't need to make works of art together, but maybe we need to meet a little more. Or I was very, when Gitanjali sent me the poster, I was like, how can you say long dure and then say we finish our projects and we meet again in exactly 12 months? This
is not long dure. We have various understandings of long dure. I mean, you're looking at is just kind of very specific. I was using it as a metaphor.
I was also
looking at it as like where it comes from historically.
But practically, for us, you can't begin anything in any way. I mean, look at Yasmina and Philip talking about that one process, like it went through two revolutions and 3 years, and it takes that long, right? So, and clearly, if we begin something in the city, it's going to take forever. We will not want to push.
Oh yeah, we can continue outside of the project also. I mean, whatever.
No, but so to finish or to present and work, in many ways goes against, like at least for us at camp, the ethos of, that's an example, like what happened in the CCTV control room and an editor of film, there's 6 years in between, right? But there's other processes and so.
I understand. No?
Is there a compulsion to make a work is one question. And within this period, and what are those modalities?
We speak about the project, because that's what we envisage. Doesn't mean to be a so-called art piece like you are used to look at an art piece. It could be an art piece, of course, but maybe through this collaboration there is a project, something which doesn't look like an art piece. You know what I mean? So it can be a project like a book. Like something which ends somewhere, out coming out of a teamwork or an exchange of all the people, and has a kind of a presentation maybe, but it doesn't have to be something like you show them in the end, there and there and there. So from this, maybe we should also be a little go away from the impression what is you do it anyway as an artist. I mean, you do anyway stuff which doesn't look like normal art that you use in the same
way. I didn't mean an art work. I just meant what
we are. What we have as practical, for practical reasons, I'm very good practical. Yeah, we have to
there's a tremendous possibility to unleash some fantastic processes with each other.
Okay.
I really, you know, but this is just quick, just this one thing we've, it's fine, we have to run. This is something we've discussed, I mean, even individually, when we met with everyone, this came up constantly. But you have to understand, I mean, this is kind of like an ideal situation, you know. We work within certain sort of really, really logistical constraints. You know? We're working with them, we're trying to see how best one can tackle these and the kind of develop a project that also has an interesting after image, that doesn't, is not about 1 year that lives outside of that 1 year. We have all this in our mind, but we also have just like completely, we're like also, you know, in some ways tied up with certain constraints which you know, of course, which we all face and we all try to circumvent as well. I understand completely what you're saying.
And we appreciate it also very much. And just as a we plan something for 1 year more or less now. And what comes after. And maybe in a year when we see next time in a conference, maybe we are just really starting, because all we've done today was, until then was maybe something like preparation. But we have funds for this year, we have maybe time for this year and the energy, and then what comes after comes after. Yeah, don't promise too much. I think we are all very, very engaged and we are so planned the whole year. I think we can't meet too much. It's always good to be together in just a few seconds. But now we have to switch.
One last question. Are these moderators now out of our lives?
I hope there will be more, but of course I hope there's plenty of us. I just want to comment one thing. I asked 35 minutes ago I asked for some issues we are really pressing, we would like to more to discuss, because we heard that over the last few days. And now there was the discussion how we go home. So I see that's obviously one of the most crucial questions we have, how we go home. Okay. I, for myself, we meet after this talk now, what we hear. We meet again for dinner, don't forget that. And maybe you, potentially, say also, after this talk, you are also involved in this discussion with you, maybe, after this discussion, there will be a short... Yeah, Lawrence, you are a short answer in connection with I just want to say thank you for everything what happened today. And I don't know if I have or we have the opportunity to speak something after this.